sit down and I'll get her in and we'll ask her. Oh, shite, I'm sorry.
Well, from the moment we started making the very first Mrs. Brown films, everybody's been asking me, how do you get into Mrs. Brown's Bloomers? Well, I'm just about to let you in. I must point out at this stage that what you're about to see in Mrs. Brown's Boys Bloomers is not indicative of the professionalism that surrounds all of the things we do within these films.
Betty and Mark had a fight and she threw him out.
Oh,
she's very upset, Mummy.
Jesus Christ. Poor Mark. Put the kettle on.
Put your fucking glasses on.
Very few mistakes are made. I mean, you might get the odd thing like this.
Meat soup, veg soup, for Christ's sake,
fucking. Okay, it's all right. You should have kept going.
You can have my bed. I don't mind.
Sorry.
Or the odd thing like that.
My name is Sir.
Yeah, pal, that's what they need. Someone who knows their own fucking name.
Other lines.
Yes.
My name is.
Yeah, pal. That's what they need. Someone who knows their own bloody line.
Name. But all in all, we make very few mistakes. That's why taking all the outtakes we have. This DVD is an hour and 20 minutes long. Sorry about that. So, okay, first of all, let's meet who everybody is that you're gonna see throughout the whole DVD. You know them from their characters, but you mightn't know them from the actors that they are, who they are, and how long they've been with the company.
I'm Rory Cowan, and I play Rory Brown. I've been with BOC Productions since the very start, Mrs. Brown's Boys since the very start. I played Rory in the radio series.
Ah, for fuck's sake!
I'm going to Rwanda.
On your honeymoon?
No, on the missions.
On your honeymoon?
No, on the missions.
Hi, I'm Danny O'Carroll. I play Buster Brady and I've been with Mrs. Brown for about 7 years.
Here, Mario! Come here. How do you own it?
Does he not talk?
No, because the line is cut.
Hi, I'm Paddy Hoolan. I play Dermot Brown, and I've been with Mrs. Brown's Boys for 6 years now.
You fucker, you.
Hiya, I'm Pat Shields, and I play Mark Brown on Mrs. Brown's DVDs. I'm with this company now 18 years.
You can't read. You can't read the safety memos, you can't read the signs. If my insurance company found out, they'd crucify me if something went wrong.
I've been working here for 15 years. I couldn't read then. What's different now?
I didn't know then. I know now. I'm sorry, son. I have no choice.
You do have a fucking choice. You own the fucking place. You're some prick. I knew you were a bollocks the minute I took this fucking job 15 years ago. You're a scumbag. I've a good right to wreck the fucking gap.
Will you?
Shove your job up your hole.
Hi, I'm Fiona O'Carroll. I play the character Marie Brown, and I've been with Mrs. Brown's Boys for the last 8 years.
Oh, I can't remember the line.
Hi, my name's Gary Hollywood. I play Dino, and I've been involved with Mrs. Brown for 8 years.
Mrs. Brown. This water comes from underground volcanic wells, and it's just as
My name is Gareth Woods, and I do second AD and standby props.
Gary, I hope you don't take this as an insult. Are you gone fucking mad?
My name is Martin Delaney. I play Cornelius, and I'm also the producer.
You're dribbling.
Hello, my name is Eilish McHugh, and I play Winnie and Mrs. Nicholson in Mrs. Brown's Boys. I joined the company approximately 11 years ago.
Hillary!
Sinbad, what do you want?
Courier printers are here.
Oh, the wedding invitation.
Oh, sorry.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Gibney and I play Kathy Brown. I've played Kathy and co-directed the Mrs. Brown DVDs since we started. And I like the writer so much that I decided to marry him.
Don't fucking annoy me, okay? Don't fucking annoy me, okay? Not to give it up.
Is this new script?
Now.
I'm not aware of these
right
lines.
Now. You're fucking...
Yeah. And you know, you will get that. You will get that all right over your nostrils.
I don't think I'm normally in this scene,
am I? Fuck off, you. Who asked you?
Right.
We're so married.
Right, somewhere near the top then, right?
You
right,
darling.
Right. I don't know what I'm doing here. I'm leaving in this DVD.
Billy to Jay. Just pass me from Billy to Jay. Father, that's all those patients are. An excuse for you to make money. I wouldn't mind, but just won't do the work to earn it. I'm making up my own words.
I give him the top. I thought Catty said Father Quinn was...
He grand. Okay.
Junk.
Last minute.
I've no time for them. I'd one of them. I knew my nana and then about my nana. I didn't know. I'd one of them on 2 weeks ago. He said if you can get. I'd one of them on 2 weeks ago. He said if you come down to the corner in 15 minutes, I'll show you me Willie.
Jeez.
Dirty.
You're like
this. Just... Sorry, I wasn't sure. I didn't know what it was supposed to say. I'm sorry.
I wasn't even with them, Mrs. Brown. I was at the doctor.
Oh, is Grandad coming out?
Hold on, I'd see.
What?
I was just behind Mrs. Brown. Go on, go. Oh.
Cos.
And then there's Rory. Rory, Rory, Rory. Rory, what did you do to your hair?
Rory Kell. He's always gone. Always.
Let's celebrate. Let's do something mad tomorrow, eh? All right. Was.
Rory Cowan, definitely Rory Cowan.
We would. I know two fellas that'd lend me a coffin and we could lay him out upstairs.
And I could do his.
Scratch. Oh, it's my concentrate,
Rory. Scratching his
face. Rory, concentrate.
We would. I know two fellas that lend me a coffin and we could lay him out upstairs.
Ah, oh, fuck.
No, Brendan, please stop.
Oh, Rory, Kevin. Everything makes Rory go. Even a sparrow farting in the garden would make Rory go.
Smells like piss, though.
How dare you? I have spent years under the finest chefs in Europe. Well, the fuck!
Rory can. Rory, Rory, Rory. What are we going to do with him?
Mammy, do you not think that, no matter how comfortable you are at home, that the time comes to leave?
No! You big wafter!
I'm not homophobic, love. I love you. It's your queer friends I don't like. Get it out.
Rory.
She loves that dog.
Rory Cowan.
Sorry. Would you like a cup of tea for yourself or your friend? Are you making a contraption?
It's not just a
little.
Rory Cowan, it costs us a fortune in tape. About 3 days behind schedule for every one of Rory's scenes. So, definitely Rory.
Frog's legs, man. Frog's legs.
Dastardly and mutely in there.
I'm sorry.
I thought the granular shot looked good.
This one probably holds the record for the longest bloomer we've had. And it features, oh yeah, Rory.
The time when I had all the bits of silver in my hair, what I was supposed to be dyeing my hair, and I came in with the phone, and all I had to say was, it's Mrs. Nicholson on the phone, and Mrs. Brown. I don't know whether she was like Mother Teresa or what she had on her head, but every time I came in, and again, it was like looking at Mrs. Brown's face, I was just gone, and I couldn't get it, just couldn't get it together at all.
She's not here. She's in town with Ringworm. No, Bingo, sorry. She's in town at the Bingo with Ringworm. Hang on.
You have a fucking cheek laughing at me with a fucking head in you like that.
I'm sorry.
Go again.
Hello? Oh, hello, Mrs. Nicholson. It's Maria's mother, Mrs. Brendan. Don't me. I can fucking do that. Even on the stage, you used to do that.
Well,
I'd be great as long as I didn't have to look at Mrs. Brown in the face. I'd be fucking.
You have a fucking cheek.
I'm sorry.
Head and you're looking for the telegraph hole.
I'm so sorry.
Still running. No. Take another one.
Right, okay. Hello? Oh, hello, Mrs. Nicholson. It's Maria. Oh, can we just do it without me?
Maybe okay, we're ready to go again.
What?
No, it's the face. I don't mean that. I mean it's to make her make a face.
It's a fucking face. Most of you are fucking lions.
And I'm the one that's the unprofessional fucker. When
we
look back at everything
that he said.
Good to go, Jen.
Did you let poetry? Did you let poetry? It's never been better. I have to do something about these fucking eyebrows. Are you troubled by acne? You think you have fucking problems?
Hello? Oh, hello, Mrs. Nicholson. Does fucking Julia Roberts have to take this?
No, but all I hear is she has to deal with this.
I'm so sorry.
We look forward to it.
I don't mean to interrupt Rory's flow, but there is one I want you to particularly look at. It's in the hairdresser's wash and blow, and Rory and Dino are both blow drying hairs, and the conversation's going on. Well, Rory makes a mistake here, and what I love, he doesn't realise it. He just keeps going.
The hairdressing scene. Off we go, hairdressing scene is set, and Brendan calls action, and Dino's delivering his lines, and Rory, out of nowhere, cuts across my lines.
Only women get pregnant.
Well, I am a woman.
You're a gobshite in a cheap John Rasha copy.
In a man's fucking body.
So we stop the scene and start again, explain to Rory, you know, no, you were too soon there. And so take two happens, and I deliver my lines, waiting for Rory this time to come in the right place, and nothing.
Well, I am a woman in a man's body.
So I turns around, and Rory is just brushing the extra's hair, just brushing away. I said, Rory, yes, you could come in with your line. I said, You're not a hairdresser, you're an actor. Oh, he said, oh, was it my turn?
I'm not a fucking gobshite either.
No, you're a gobshite. You didn't let him finish his line.
Oh, did I not?
No. Then we do it again. Okay.
You're not having a baby, and you're certainly not pregnant.
Oh, how hurtful.
Only women get pregnant.
Well, I am a woman in a man's body.
You're a gobshite in a John Rasha copy.
Oh, how di... Sheep? Oh!
I never even said sheep. The important word, and I didn't say it.
If there's one sequence that typifies everybody else trying to do their job and Rory collapsing, it has to be the family counselling scene. In this, Cathy is training to be a psychologist, and this is part of her training, is to have a family counselling session.
Mark, you forgive me?
Yes.
For what?
Tell her, son, tell her. To her face.
You said you hated me.
Yes.
I forgive you.
Goodbye.
But Mark, you're the one that was in the wrong.
Excuse me. Now, excuse me. Call me old-fashioned. But he forgives you and he's in the wrong.
I was ready for this. The counselling scene. I knew it was going to be a tough scene to shoot, a lot of people in it, and it was going to be a long scene. So everything was going along great, and then suddenly Brendan, as Brendan does, decided to just go off on one, and said,
"What kind of jumped up hiddly diddly giddly out?
Hurdy 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 hiddly diddly giddly giddly giddly
triddly diddly shite bag widdly
loud psychology is this?"
I have no idea where it came from. I just went into it, and maybe it was a burst of adrenaline. I was supposed to say, what kind of jumped up psychology is this? And the next thing I heard coming out is, what kind of jumped up higgly piggly wiggly diggly liggly biggity miggity hoppity giggity goppity bobbity bobbity goo psychology? And I knew as soon as I said it that everybody was having a giggle, but it was no problem because you couldn't giggle in that scene and it would be like the family were taking the piss out of Cathy. But when it came to the next line, unfortunately, it was Rory's.
If you want hilly gilly gilly gilly, ooly 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 boolies. Say something, look. Anything. Let me know you're there. Go to the light, Rory. Go to the light.
She made a big thing about Dino's peruke.
Is there a tissue around?
Yeah. She made a big thing about Dino's peruke and...
The best way I can explain the next clip I'm going to show you is to show you the actual clip that ran in the DVD. Watch what I mean. It's in a cafe, and basically it's Dermot coming in and talking to Mario, who owns the cafe. So have a look at this. This is what came out of it.
All right, Mario, you don't look busy.
Not busy? You should have been here an hour ago. The espresso machine's acting up, the toilets keep blocking. I can't get any staff and I'm up to me eyes.
She looks like she wants to work.
She does. She's a great worker, but her English isn't great. Watch this. Helena.
Da?
Can you get me a toasted ham sandwich?
Жареный бутерброд?
A ham sandwich.
Ah. Держи.
See?
Jesus, what'd you get if you asked for a banana?
Shut up.
The girl you're seeing working behind the counter, Marina, who also you might have noticed worked in the travel agency, she was only available to do her shots. So when we cut back and forward to her, you can see that she's doing a good job. Unfortunately, she had to go. So when we were shooting Michael's shots, Michael Coughlin, Mario, we didn't have her, so we had to have somebody stand in. Garrett, who you'll meet a bit later, Mr. Propsman, decided he would stand in for it. So every time Michael turned away from the camera to look at Marina, he was looking at Garrett.
Not busy? You should have been here an hour ago. Not busy? You should have been here an hour ago. The espresso machine's acting up. Fuck.
She looks like she wants to work.
Garrett was just so funny because he was just doing all the actions and, you know, trying to be a girl off camera, so Michael couldn't keep a straight face at all.
She looks like she wants to work.
She does. She's a great worker.
Unfortunately, yes, it was my fault because Marina, who was actually acting in it, was gone and I was doing a stand-in for her, trying to be as much as her as possible to help the actors. And unfortunately, it all went wrong. I was trying to do the fold, I was trying to do everything she was doing. Didn't realize that I should just stand there and do nothing.
She looks like she wants to work.
What are you trying to say?
Look at me, look at me.
Well, I just made my face a complete blank canvas. I could give no expression, and I was like, and that sent them worse.
She does. She's a great worker.
Quiet, please.
Quiet.
Watch this.
What?
Mammy, have you a minute to talk?
What is it? You're not after getting some girl pregnant, are you?
Mammy.
I've known for years. I just couldn't say it to you. You're crap. You're good at some things, love. But football isn't.
Oh, and I was telling me mother, Mrs. Brown, that I was gay. It was out in the back garden and she was hanging up the washing. And the thing that I remember is, looking back on it, I just grabbed these pair of tights that were on the line and just shoved them right into my face. Now, I don't know who owned those tights. I don't even know if they were new, if they were old, whatever it was. I'll never forget that.
You're crap. And when you run along the pitch, your Mickey sticks out under the Knicks. Your knob dangles down. You're crap. But if you finish,
lunch break.
Without a shadow of a doubt, when somebody makes a bloomer, there's always somebody else to blame. The person who gets blamed the most? Paddy. Paddy Houlihan, who plays Dermot Brown. He's just dreadful.
Paddy, fuck off.
Look down at the girls. Archer.
Paddy, fuck. Paddy's messing. Paddy Houlihan. I just look at him every time I'm doing a scene and he's smiling at me and blowing kisses. he's the worst. Look, what you and Maria have now, it's great. Stop fucking smiling at me, Paddy.
It's Pepsi. Pepsi's a liar. He can't keep a straight face when we're doing a scene and he always blames me, and it is him.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have a small announcement to make about the raffle.
What about the raffle? Fuck off, you wanker. Fuck off, Paddy, he's making me laugh. You don't even want me. He's sticking his fucking tongue out. Get out of here.
Why don't you just go home, Mark, and talk to Betty?
I rang her this morning. She hung up.
All right. Sorry.
Rang her this morning. She hung up. I rang her this morning. She hung up.
Alright.
He's the worst. He makes us go all the time. And you can ask anybody on the set about that. He's ridiculous. He can't keep a straight face. He messes up his lines. He's very funny though.
Why don't you just go home, Mark, and talk to Betty?
She hung up. Fuck yes! You shit!
46.
Six.
Do you have to fucking comment?
Yes.
I rang her this morning. You're not fucking interested, are you, Phoebe?
Okay. Let's do it. Come on, but you can do this. Concentrate on it. Imagine your life depends on it. And it fucking does.
Danny, will you not fucking leave? It's Danny that gets the giggles and ruins it for both of us. The two boys are just not professional. And I am.
I can't work with these fucking amateurs, you know? It's me bollocks.
Are you trying to look sincere, will you?
Why don't you just go home, Mark, and talk to Betty?
We wait all this length of time.
You are a bollocks, Pepsi.
Well, Paddy is bad. But when you put Paddy together with Danny, Buster Brady, I can't get them to shut up. They just get the giggles.
Oh, damn it. Just like the old days. You, the expert breaker, and me, the genius planner, silent and invisible, moving from place to place.
You're a fucking magpie.
Sorry. Just like the old days, Demo. You, the expert breaker, and me, the genius planner, silent and invisible, down in the Arctic, like a polar bear, waiting.
Oh, damn it. Just like the old days. You, the expert breaker, and me, the genius planner, silent and invisible, like a shadow, moving from place to place in the Arctic with the panda bears.
Still running.
That was because you were told to just, you know, make it up yourself. You'd listen to what.
Yeah, but
Brennan
you
said.
Wouldn't bloody go with me.
Speaking.
You were making me laugh. I know, but if you look back in the outtake, you just won't stop laughing.
It was funny.
Yeah, well.
Camouflage.
Okay, when you do camouflage, look, the planes in the sky. You know,
are
the ships
under
sea?
Yeah.
You cannot see them, even though they are there.
Like a shadow, moving from place to place. Like planes in the sky that cannot be detected by radars.
Ships. Shut the fuck up, Buster, will you?
And
not
again,
finished.
And again?
Loads to do.
Well, Dermo's what Buster really wants to be, I suppose, but there must, I don't fucking know what else to say. Help me. My first interview. You're fucking me up.
And your last.
You know, I can't fucking talk, sorry.
In the scene, I was eating a chocolate muffin, and every time I took a bite out of the muffin, it was so dry in my mouth, so every time my lines were coming up, I was panicking and trying to swallow it as quickly as I could. I think actually, every time I did talk, I was spitting bits of it on Paddy and whatnot. It was all caught in my teeth, and that was, it was a funny scene. It was just, it was great. No.
Look at Mario. Paddy, will you fuck off?
Paddy, I'm not doing anything.
Just turn around or something.
How does he do it?
Paddy, will you fucking stop?
There's a line in the script where where Paddy, we're trying to sell tickets and Paddy comes out with Paddy start getting all excited, saying that we have to sell tickets and we'll sell hundreds, and Buster being Buster, his line was meant to be thousands. And as it was coming up to that part, coming up to it, I sort of forgot my line, what it was meant to say, and just in a split second came out,
fucking millions.
In the script it was meant to be whatever the line was, and you just decided to go with fucking millions. So it was news to me, I never heard it before.
First of all, we need to get more tickets printed.
More tickets.
Thousands.
Fucking millions.
Right. First of all, we need to get more tickets printed.
More tickets.
Thousands.
Fucking millions. Paddy, I can see you, for fuck's sake, will you stop? And you're trying to hide it, it's not working, will you stop?
You can't look at Danny when you're trying to concentrate, he just starts smiling, so if you're in front of the camera and he's off.
It was me that was on camera, and you were making me laugh. So you had to turn around so I could do my scene. Don't be blaming me.
It was you. It's always you.
Hey, right.
What's the problem? I'm not doing that.
Look at him.
We've already established that doesn't work.
I'll turn it around the right.
We're actually getting it back together again. You call me fucking Bosco.
Bosco?
Bosco. That's what you're... That's what the whole thing got me started on again.
I remember calling you Bosco.
Instead of Bosco.
A club or something. And not the swimming club, but...
Bosco.
Go from the top.
No. Okay, let me tell you what's happening in this one. Rory is serving the soup to Mrs. Nicholson and Mrs. Brown. Now, it's all in the script, except for the bit where Mrs. Brown puts her finger in the soup. And Rory wasn't expecting that. What's his reaction?
Tell me, Agnes, what's for main course?
Salmon.
Oh, lovely. My absolute favourite.
Oh, good, because we're getting a whole tin each.
Dinner is served.
Oh, no. Thank you, love.
Oh, thank you.
Rory, this is cold.
You see, the way Brendan works is he tells me, like, what I've got to do, but he doesn't tell me what he's got to do. So I knew exactly what I had to do, what I had to say, what my lines were.
Yours is fucking cold. His, hers is cold as well. It's fucking cold.
Agnes.
Just stuck his finger into Mrs. Nicholson's soup. And I couldn't believe that he did that.
Rory.
You're putting your finger in someone else's
soup. It's fucking cold.
Agnes, I think this is probably Vichy Soise.
No, it's soup.
I'll get you another bowl.
Well, Rory just couldn't keep a straight face. I mean, I can't look at Rory in that scene because I would just lose it completely.
We went and done it the second time. I still fell around the place laughing. The idea of putting your finger in somebody else's soup.
Rory, this is cold.
I think it's supposed to be.
No, don't be fucking ridiculous. It's cold. Yours is cold as well. It's cold. It's fucking freezing,
Agnes,
Rory.
Agnes, I think it's probably Vichy Soise.
Well, I don't care. No, it's soup. It's not going to be cold. Rory, right, take it back and get you a hot one. Tend to put it in the microwave for a few minutes, all right? Good man. Is he fussy?
Would you ever give him a fucking chance?
I'm going to do that.
I know you were, but he didn't know that.
He did. That's the second time he did it.
I thought you were mad.
And lots of quiet, and in 3, 2, 4.
Tell me. Tell me, Agnes.
Yeah.
What's for main course?
Salmon.
Oh, lovely. My absolute favourite.
Oh, good. Because we're getting a whole tin each.
Dinner is served.
Oh, lovely. Thank you, love.
Oh, thank you, dear.
Rory. Rory, this is fucking cold. Rory.
You're wasting film, Rory.
I haven't even stuck me fucking finger in anything yet. You just tell me it's supposed to be cold.
So I'm really sorry.
You know, professionalism is one of the things I think is very, very important when making a film. And one of the things that's most unprofessional and drives me crazy is a mobile phone on the set. Can you believe this next clip? Not only was there a phone on the set, it belonged to the soundman.
That's the soundman's phone.
Oh,
how many have we got so far? How many have we got so far?
Do you embarrass him now, so?
I'll ring you back.
Let's take one more.
None of this on Bergerac.
Damn it. I hope your children grow up big and strong. And I hope that phone stops beeping.
When I was 25, I could piss over the Phoenix Park wall.
Did you have a vibrating mobile at the time?
Clyde.
Hello?
If we could get just one good job.
I have it. When you're ready, Mr. Foley.
So what I've done is, I've banned mobile phones from the set. Nobody's allowed to have a mobile phone on the set. It's just not professional.
Okay, quiet.
Quiet! Give this second to get Thomas Pate ready for it.
See the
phone. It's yours.
It's
yours. One more hands up, please.
Sorry. In 3, 2.
So unprofessional.
Well, so far we've concentrated on the boys. I don't know what I'm going to do with the girls. Oh, they come across very prim and proper on the screen, but you put 2 of them together, or 3, you just end up with the giggles. They're nearly as bad as Rory.
No, okay. No, I'll say it again for you, just instead of everybody else.
Yeah, settle down there now.
The cue is Victoria from John, and it's everybody whispers. Oh, Victoria, Victoria. But you do the Victoria, it's Victoria.
Sorry.
John, say Victoria twice and leave a gap between them. So the first Victoria, you pay. Fuck off, girls. I'm watching you, you brats. When I say Victoria. Come on. Everybody whisper. Victoria. Except yous. Okay. You say it as you would normally say it. Okay. In 3, 2, in 3.
Just give me a second, please. I'm sorry.
Professional, Gerald, come
levels.
On.
Her sugar levels, they're not
be right. Professional, for fuck's sake.
She just had a rabbit died.
tears in your eyes.
Thank God it wasn't our pussy. Your pussy died years ago, didn't you?
Could we have a message?
All right, now come on, quiet, girls, let's go. No playing, no messing, let's do it. In three. Ooh. There's smoke there, Nick.
That's it.
You'd miss two, Jess, wouldn't you?
Jenny and Marion are the worst. Put them two together and who knows what'll happen. You could be about an hour waiting to get the right shot. Sorry. I thought I got the question first off somebody's. What is that going? Do I go now?
No, we're just doing the answers.
Right,
bad
okay.
Look in your
okay.
eyes going, I don't know.
Sorry.
I met Marion when we did Agnes Brown together. The movie. I'd been a big fan of hers as a stage actress before that. I think she's fantastic. And we just clicked and we've been really close friends, and she only has to walk through the door and she makes me laugh.
Well,
you only missed it by hiding.
Marion Fionnuala, who plays Betty, and Fiona, who plays Maria, when the four of us get together, I don't know what happens. It's just, we only have to look at each other and we're gone. It's great fun.
Whining doesn't mean fucking whispering. Quiet.
We're allowed to
open with a laugh.
Right.
We're
going to
open with a laugh on action, okay? And then Betty, take a sip of your drink and put your hands down. Sound. Camera. 3, 2, 1. Sound. I
think
it's
Action.
A toast. Men are bastards.
Men are bastards!
You know, it was always the same in this house.
Take it again, there's a bit of biscuit on your bottom lip. Okay, right from the... Yep. Just leave the board, we're grand. Here we go, set. Get a soggy biscuit on your...
A bit of chip on your lip.
Jesus Christ!
Me? Say that? Never. I'd never say anything like that. What can I say? I didn't lick it off the floor.
Come here. Are you coming to the quiz now?
Well, I'll be there, but Mick can't.
Ah, shite. We could have been a team of four. Where are you going to eat? We could follow you.
What? We
I'm sorry.
Well, one of the great joys of playing Corny is getting to work with Marion O'Dwyer. Just having Marion there for every scene, it makes my job very easy. I just get to sit there and look good.
Aww. Why don't you come out with stuff? Fuck.
Sorry.
I came in and I sat down and I started to cry, my big dramatic piece, and suddenly Jenny asked me a question and I hadn't read the script, to be honest, and I didn't know what to say, so I just didn't know what to do.
What are you crying for?
Wouldn't you miss Seaman? I miss Seaman, I do. I miss Seaman. Good goalkeeper, I thought.
Jackal was supposed to go into this death role, you know, this as if he was dying, but actually all I got from him was and it was very, very hard to keep a straight face.
Your brother Johnny called. He said he might get in to see you. Oh, and your sister called from America. Jesus, isn't it gas? They're all calling. They wouldn't call you when you were alive.
Oh,
sorry.
No.
It wasn't it?
Floyd.
Yeah?
You're not in for fucking ages.
Oh.
There's a part in the script there that says, enter Floyd. That's where you're in.
Right on.
Good morning, love.
Morning, ma.
You're all dressed up. What's the occasion?
Well, I'm going for a promotion. For an interview. For a promotion. Senior Porter.
Drop in here anytime you fucking like. You know, we're not paying you as Charlie Chaplin. We want you to say the words.
I am my own special creation. I bang my own drum. Sorry, you'll have to fucking that up.
That's all okay.
Thomas.
Yes.
How are you? Cathy. Cathy, love. Cathy, I hope you don't take this as an insult. Are you gone fucking mad? It was very simple. All he had to do was take out a bunch of tinsel, shake it, and the bits would drop down. Now, that's not difficult. Thomas.
Yes?
How are you?
Oh.
Cathy. Cathy. Cathy, I hope you don't...
I didn't realise that if you had to shake the tinsel to get the little bits out, but I was giving out clumps and let it drop, covering them, and they could hardly see each other.
Cathy, love, I hope you don't take this as an insult, but in you, I see myself. 5-10 years ago, running through the fields naked, lying by the canal, sucking a fisherman's friend. Now, Cathy, I want you to know, go out and... I can see the little hand over me. Go.
Sorry, I'm just trying.
It's okay, I know that. Oh, very.
My name is Gareth Woods, and I do second... I do second AD and standby props.
3, 2, action. Thomas.
Yeah.
There's big lumps.
Thomas, is that you? Is that you, Thomas? Thomas, are you there?
Yeah, somewhere.
Father Quinn? Louder. Louder, Father Quinn, louder.
Father Quinn?
No, a bit louder.
In you go, Andrew.
Okay, come on, put
it. You bastard, hold up.
You can sit down.
I don't want to sit down.
Ah, suit yourself.
Oh, don't you worry, I will.
Like you always do.
I'd a good teacher.
Talk to the hand, because the face ain't listening.
Sit down, Dingo.
Hold on, I'll leave.
Dingo.
In amongst all of this chaos on the set, I really have to acknowledge those who don't make bloomers. I've never seen Grandad make a bloomer. I've never seen Father Quinn make a bloomer.
Other way round.
I've never seen Thomas make a bloomer. So in fairness, wait a minute. There's somebody who says that they never make bloomers, and they really do. Who would that be?
Mistakes. I don't make mistakes. I never made a mistake. Have a look at the DVD. I never made one.
Tell you what's up. The man I've been just working for is missing. The black Rhoda watch. Rhoda? Rather watch. Ew.
What's up?
I'll tell you what's up. The man I've just been working for is missing the black Rhoda watch. Fucking Rhoda watch again.
Fuck's sake.
I'll tell you what's up. The man I've just been working for is missing the black Lada watch. Lada! Fuck it!
There was a black one. There was a Rhoda. There was a Lada. That comes on four wheels. And the famous Rado, which I never got to say.
I'll tell you what's up. The man I've just been working for is missing a very expensive black watch.
I didn't make any beer moves.
Not all of the mistakes are accidental. Particularly this one coming up, which features Mikey Nolan, Mr. Foley. We brought him in for a day's shooting, but he only had two lines. So he was moaning a bit about only having two lines and having to come all the way from Cork to do his two lines. So what we decided to do was, we decided to make sure that no matter what way he did those lines, it was wrong. And this is the result.
Drink, Dermot.
No, Mr. Foley.
Hold on, sorry. Put the emphasis on Dermot rather than the drink, you know what I mean?
Okay,
try that.
Drink, Dermot. Sex on the beach, Dermot.
Okay. Let's go back and try it. It's good without the laugh.
Stop
it's
laughing.
Good.
Sex on the beach, Dermot.
I wouldn't mind no wank.
I just winded you up, mate.
And it's all on tape.
All on tape.
Mr. Foley.
Drink, Dermot.
No, just fuck him out.
I wish.
Mr. Foley.
Drink, Dermot.
No, just fuck him out.
I wish.
I forgot.
Cut, or action, fucking cut. Fucking action, cut me bollocks, whatever. Run it!
Rory, quit me!
I'm coming, Jesus Christ, I'm not on fucking wheels.
I just have to look at his face, and I start laughing. I see Mrs. Brown's face, I laugh. And even when we're working, and I sort of look down, he keeps saying, look at me face, son, when you're talking to me. And of course, then I just corpse. All the time he does it.
Mammy, do you not think that no matter how comfortable you are at home, the time comes to leave?
Go.
Fucking cunt. No counselor for me and father, you must be joking. Counselors, we settle things like adults into a room on our own, and I'd let him fiddle me fanny and then he'd fuck me up the arse. We never needed counsellors. I just realised I have the wrong cigarette in my hand.
I was looking at that and I couldn't say that.
I was in love. I was in insane. I was in love. Ah, Fred, would you just give me one fucking reaction?
Yeah, sure. I have moments when I do play around a little bit on the set. I think it's essential. I think it keeps everybody a little bit up and it stops me getting bored. It's the worst problem that you can have is if you get bored on the set. And if I get bored, you can sure the viewer's going to get bored. And it's not easy being me.
I can't take you seriously like that.
You're saying to your father in a frock and a bra.
You look like something out of Star Trek.
King has on this. We come in peace, peace to kill. He's gone.
Is he gone?
Yes. He's gone down the surgery.
Fix your wig, will you?
You don't need a death certificate, man.
Oh, yes, I do.
He's due 25 years service. He come us up.
Is he gone?
Yes, he's gone down to surgery to get me this. It's not me.
Am I going? I'm
going to fucking bastard.
Fancy a drink, young lady?
I do, kind sir. Mammy, we were just leaving.
Well, hold your fucking horses. So, who's hoping to get their Mickey sucked tonight? That's not the line. I thought you were going to put me in a home.
What?
Ah, ma. Why would we do that?
She's in the script.
You're so right, Jenny. You were so right.
You know, you were always my favourite.
Oh, no. Mommy.
You were always my favourite.
Oh, no, Mommy.
And you're a cunt.
You're a cunt.
We're a cunt.
You
fucking. What a fucking liberty! Fucking liberty! Garlic bread! Fucking garlic bread! Are you having a laugh? You're having a laugh!
Okay, still running, guys.
Okay. Oh, no. Okay.
You were always my favourite. Okay, still running. You were always my favourite. You were always my favourite.
Oh, no. You are a horrible person.
I did nothing.
I did nothing.
I did nothing. Nothing.
Still rolling.
You're upset, love, aren't you?
Ma, the vet said Spartacus was too to fuck off.
You go on. I'll follow you down. Go on.
Monitor's broken.
Well, you hit your mother.
Dad is just a very funny character, on set, off set, everywhere you go, and it's very hard to keep a straight face when he's on set with you, especially in your scene. But he's a very, very funny man. And it gets everybody going, keeps everybody up high spirits on set, and it's great.
I can't do this scene to you like that, please. Fuck off. Now fuck off. I'm friending you.
Tingles, Captain. Tingles. Tingles, Captain. Tingles.
You know, it's working. It's working.
Hey, you! Don't you talk to me like that! Jesus Christ, I'm on Weight Watchers, can't you? Well, you can fuck off! Wait for me!
But I can't do this scene. I can't do this scene. Please put your wig on properly. You're some cunt.
Hello. I just want to say a few words on behalf of the George and George Street. You're all very welcome. And you're a model for your hole.
Well, you're not. You're a cunt.
I just said that's your mother.
Sorry.
I just tried to speak to you.
Well, you're...
I just tried to speak to you.
Well, all the celebrities were really great to work with, but I've particular admiration for Keith Duffy. I got to do a whole episode with Keith, and very professional and great to work with. And if you look back at the first DVD that we did, Keith played a sort of rock and roll style vet, and he was terrific. And that was long before he even started in Coronation Street. He's a pleasure to work with and a pleasure to direct.
Viagra?
Not exactly, Mr. Nicholson. But it does have a similar effect on a dog. Well, we've a little bit to go before we get there. A shot first. Little prick, eh? Little prick. But if that doesn't work in 24 hours, we'll revert to the, fuck it.
Mary Kennedy. Beautiful and a real lady.
Oh, don't be silly. Leave that to us. This is Ireland. You got a heartbeat? You're alive? We'll get you a mortgage.
That would have to be Michael Carruth, the boxer. Fabulous guy.
Does it hit me? Hannah! Hannah said you wanker, hit me!
Robbie Keane, say.
And if this be so, we would defile a temple. Oh, sorry.
No, who? Hang on. If this be so, who would defile a temple?
And if this be so, who would defile you? Fuck.
Who would defile?
Well, you don't get Ronan Keaton to be your taxi driver every day. That was pretty cool. You see, I have to get home before my father wanks the dog.
Jesus, full speed ahead then.
Alan News, TV3.
I have a jetpack. I could fly around the car showroom if you like.
You can.
I can in me bollocks.
Ken Doherty. He was great, Craig.
Hello. Wait to get the fuck out.
Oh, off the top of my head now, Eamon Coughlin comes to mind. A true champion and a true gentleman.
Maria! Maria! A skeleton girl named Maria! Maria! I've just met the girl named Maria!
Okay, too fast.
Maria! I've just met the girl named Maria!
Was it all right?
Yeah, we nailed it. I have a particular affinity to radio. So, Steve Cooper and Mick Mulcahy, two brilliant radio presenters, were a pleasure for me to have along. I think when you get a chance to work with your friends, that's always a great, makes it a great day. And working with Punches de Rosa, who's been a friend for many years, and at the drop of a hat, just came in and did the scene. With Danny, and he was fabulous.
So what's your name?
Joe Duffy, class act. Should have been a priest, actually.
Do you, Dermot, take Maria to be your lawfully married husband?
Kay Bourne.
Sorry.
I'm trying to get the bitch to mate.
Couldn't bother if I was you. Leave her in the greenhouse. Know what I mean?
Well, Pegasus, I think it's a visit to the vet.
So you see, everybody likes somebody or other, but one that we all agreed on. Who just made us laugh on set, on camera and off camera. He was a treat to work with, and he's one of my best friends. And he's...
Peter Kay.
Without a doubt, Peter Kay.
Oh, that would have to be my friend Susan Kay's husband. That's Peter Kay.
Peter Kay was great, Craig.
Peter Kay, genuine guy, lovely guy.
Peter Kay, it was just, the whole day was just fantastic.
Concepta, is it cheaper to go to Canada via Geneva?
Канада – это очень хорошая страна, очень прекрасная. Я советую туда поехать каждому.
What city?
Toronto.
Toronto.
Oh, okay.
Lovely place. Well, I'm looking here, and it says it'd be cheaper to fly to Geneva. Right. Are we still going?
Yeah.
All right. Going. Does it say wreck?
No.
In the top right-hand corner.
Could go by Geneva.
Right, okay. What city?
Toronto.
Toronto. All right, I've had a look on the computer here, and it's actually cheaper if you go... Now, I've had a look on the computer, and it's actually cheaper to go by Geneva. Sorry, not by... to go... To, hang on.
Now let's see. You could go by Geneva, that'd be the cheapest.
Now let's see.
You could go by a via. Fucking via. Now let's see. Buy. Not via. Buy.
Good, now let's see.
Ah! You could go via fucking via. You could go by Geneva.
Right. Let's have a look now.
You could go by Geneva, that'd be the cheapest.
I'll take this, Conceptor, thank you. Hello, welcome, madam. My name's Jason.
Hello.
Welcome to the shop. Can I help you? Nice Spanish holiday, perhaps somewhere exotic?
No, I wouldn't go anywhere.
Sit down.
I wouldn't go anywhere. I couldn't pronounce.
Sit down. I have wheels.
Look. Very nice.
I have wheels.
Very good.
Yes. Whereabouts would you like to go?
I'd like to visit me sister.
Sister, whereabouts is she?
Canada.
Canada, beautiful, beautiful part of the world. Beautiful. Let's have a look. There it is, like a little baby's head. That's Canada. Yes. You ever been there?
No.
No. Well, you will. You'll go.
I'm looking forward to it.
Whereabouts is she in Canada?
56 Hillcrest Drive.
What city?
Toronto.
Well, I'm seeing here now. Yeah, that's all right. Was that a better beginning?
Yeah, I think it was, yeah. Much better beginning. Now we're going on singles. Do what I want to do now. Wouldn't that be nice?
Thanks.
Okay, we can.
Well, that's it. That's the total amount, one lady, of all the bloomers we made making Mrs. Brown. My thanks to all the celebrities who took part, to all the crew we've had right down through the years, and to all the cast. I hope you enjoyed the DVDs, but I want you to know one thing. We make mistakes. We work really hard. It gets a little bit stressful at times. But the one thing we do, we laugh. We laugh a lot. Called Love on a Humpback Bridge. It's very good, actually.
Right, got it. Thanks, mate, Mrs. Brown.
What the fuck was that?
What? Okay, we're moving on.
Great shot.
What do you think of the pink?
Pink?
What? Oh, Jesus. I see it now. What do you think? What do you think of the pink?
Pink?
Yeah.
Nice chandeliers, Mr. Fowley.
Ah, thanks, Dermot. What do you think of...
Nice chandeliers, Mr. Fowley.
Ah, thanks, Dermot. €500 each they cost me. Just not going to do it.
Danny, I can't see you in shop.
Oh, Danny, get out.
Right. That's it then. Bags all packed. I can remember the line. Ah, hiya. Hiya,
Do you know, Maria, you're a fine mother.
Thanks, Mrs. Byrne. Thanks very much.
And she was four. She ate the arm of my Cindy.
So, Maria, how are the arrangements going?
Oh. Oh, not open, she's laughing. She's laughing at me.
Why would she laugh at you?
Exactly, we've loads of dogs here. Now will you describe the dog.
Oh yeah, sorry. She's 14 years old. She's brown.
Bit of a limp, isn't she?
No, look. She's dead.
Exactly, we've loads of dogs here. Now will you describe the dog.
She's 14. She barks with a lisp. Kind of moof, moof.
Fuck your mammy.
Sure, last year, didn't you have your christening here?
My christening?
And following year.
Last year.
I know I'm looking young. Oh,
hallelujah.
You know, sorry, Mike, don't mind me. Well, I'm the wedding arranger. Planner. Shit. You got me saying that. No, that's the line. No, it's wedding planner.
No, wedding
no ranger.
Is there? Yeah, I get it wrong.
Sorry.
Sure, Sharon McGugan, how could you think I'd overcharge you? Last year. Sorry.
During your christening.
Sure, didn't you have your own christening here last year?
I knew it.
Ah, Sharon McGugan.
You didn't have your own christening here.
Sorry, Sharon. She's laughing at me. Right. Asher, didn't we have our christening here?
Did you and me? Did you and me christen together here? You and me? And you? In the pond, having a swim.
Right.
We have our own christening.
Asher, didn't you have...
I can't do it now.
Sure, didn't you have your own christening here? Catty.
Yeah?
Do you know those little polyps you do get in your saddlebags?
What?
What I'm talking about. Okay, we're going. What, love?
Did you ever wonder what Daddy saw in you?
What kind of fucking question is that?
No, I don't mean anything bad. I just wondered what you thought that
did too. That he had hold them has back here for all our Polish friends. Look from both sides, anything but.
Why your money?
Why your money? Dupont. I have an itch.
An itch? What kind of an itch? Allowed.
And I'm delighted to declare this wonderful traditional bar, Fagan's.
Foley's.
I'm waiting for you to hit me. And I'm delighted to declare this wonderful traditional bar here, Foley's, officially.
Okay.
Oh, I said Foley's, did I? Fuck it, sorry.
What Irishman is the manager for Sunderland Football Club? Just text your answers now to the Roy Keane Football Competition at Chate to Johnny Ten. What Irishman is the manager for Sunderland Football Club? Text your answers now to the Roy Keane Competition at Chate for Johnny fucking the fuck. He's bombed my hands! Oh, these hands!
Keep rolling. Close the door behind you.
We struggled through that. I hope you enjoyed the DVD that you've just seen. This track is a bonus track, just for you. It's a mini documentary that was made by Paddy Houlihan Dermo and Danny O'Carroll Buster. And it was shot and edited by Michael Carroll. It'll give you a little bit of an insight into really what it's like to be working on a day shoot, and this is only over one day, on Mrs. Brown. Particularly look for some of the interviews in Foley's Bar. I can explain them. I can't excuse them. We always save the Foley's Bar shoot to the last day because we have real beer in the taps. And when the shooting is finished, we empty the taps. I was a little bit inebriated, just slightly. Action!
You drink, young lady?
I do, kind sir.
Maybe the feckers hanging around the street, that was it.
Mammy, we were just leaving.
Well, hold your fucking horses now. So, this is Slick Mick the Dick.
So, Keith, who are you playing?
I'm playing there.
Michael O'Leary.
Michael O'Leary?
Michael O'Leary, yeah.
How'd you find it?
Well, it's the best way to get it. If you come down Kilshane Cross and take a right and stick on all the back roads coming around, you can't miss the place.
So what's it like working with Brendan?
Ah, it's great fun. It's great. It's great to come home and work with fantastic actors like yourself, Paddy. You know.
Fancy a drink, young lady?
Okay. I think you're doing the Tracy Barlow. We're fucking disgusting.
Come on.
Okay.
Is it different from Kerry?
Yeah, it's very different, yeah. You can kind of have a bit of fun with this, get the job done. I think you get the job done a lot quicker when you're having a bit of fun. Sometimes people get too panicky about trying to get something finished and they don't get it done, and they're screaming at us in there, so we better go. But it was great fun, great to work with Ben. Hope it goes well. See you all soon.
Thanks, Keith.
Rory Kill, what is the part you play in the show?
I play the gay son, Rory.
Oh! Oh! It's me back, Mammy. Oh, I feel like I'm 2 foot tall. Oh. Me and Dina were riding up in the park.
Camp is Christmas.
Okay.
Which I have to dig down very, very deep to get to.
And what do you think of the actors you're playing with, especially your partner, Gary Hollywood?
He's a lot to let. No, really. No, Gary is brilliant. Gary is absolutely fantastic. Really like him. I like them all.
Honestly?
Most of them.
What kind of an idiot do you think I am? You said it, not me!
Hello again, my friend Lens. Now, I've been asked the question, how did I initially meet Brendan? Well, I hope you've got an awful lot of tape or memory in there, because it's a very, very long story. Now, initially, I had a position, if you'll excuse the use of the phrase, with an educational theatre company. Now, one day, excuse me, interruption, not just yet. Anyway, initially, yes, I had a position with a theatrical education company, and it involved... Well, yes. It involved driving an extremely large vehicle over huge distances.
Dustbin truck.
Right again. You'll laugh when you hear this. Not a lot. And unfortunately, I had warned the company, I had a worn tyre. Cut a long story short, anyway. The tyre burst at over 80 miles an hour and I crashed. Now, I was injured.
Rubbage all over the road. M1 block for weeks.
Thank you, Harry. Much appreciated. Those interjections, what would it be without them? Quite good is the answer, you're probably thinking. Anyway, I was at home recovering, and who should come on my televisual device but Brendan O'Carroll himself. And I thought, there's somebody who needs a hand up in life. So what I did was, I wrote to him. I sent him my CV, curriculum vitae, and my photograph. And lo and behold, in the blink of an eye, 6 bloody months later, he called me and said, I've got a position for you as an actor in my new play, The Horse. Well, I didn't realise we had a bad telephonic link. He actually said, the course, of course. Of course, the course. And anyway, but a week later, I met him in the grand old city of Glasgow. There's something the matter with Glasgow, because it's going round and round. Sure, you remember that one. Anyway, it was a few days later, but however, back to the story. I met Brendan and he said, what's your name? I said, Mike Pyatt, and he said, you've got the gig, lad, only with an accent that I didn't understand.
3, 2
Mammy, Father Quinn is here.
Oh, that fucking... Grimes, I'll be out in a minute.
Make yourself comfortable, Father Quinn. Mammy will be out to you now in a minute. I have to fly. I have a couple coming in to practice marriage counselling.
Doing God's work, eh?
Yeah, see ya.
Bye now.
How are you doing, Ken?
Hiya, how are you?
What are you playing in this production?
I actually play a Mormon, would you believe? And it's actually been good fun because myself and Robbie Kane, I play 2 Mormons. That the priest isn't too happy about because he thinks he's still his parishioner. So, we actually knock on the door and we go into Mrs. Brown's house and it's all a good bit of fun.
In 3, 2 Hello.
Wait to get the fucking door off. He said hello into the fucking letterbox. Hello. I'll open it that when I get to there. I'll give you a nod.
It's actually a good experience. I've done anything like this before, so we had a great laugh. Like, Brendan's so funny, he just cracks you up all the time, and we couldn't stop laughing most of the time.
3, 2
How long have we been here?
4 hours.
Cut.
Well, I know Brendan, would you believe, since I was about 13 or 14, and not many people know this, but Brendan actually used to manage a snooker player, and... So that's how I knew him. His name was Paddy Brown. He was from Finglas and he was a good friend of Brendan's. And Brendan used to sort of sponsor him and manage him. And when we used to go over and play for the Irish team, Brendan used to come with us over to Prestatyn in North Wales, which was a holiday camp. And he wasn't even doing comedy at that time. He used to tell loads of jokes and everybody loved him. But he wasn't like doing obviously what he's doing now. And I think that's how he sort of got into it, because he was just naturally funny. And that's how I met him. I've known him ever since. And He's a good friend, and we get on really well, and we always have a good laugh together. And he always rings me up when I'm playing and texting me, you know, to wish me all the best. And you know, I appreciate that very, very much. He's a very, I treat him as a good friend, and I hope he does too. Maybe not after this production.
I play Dino, who is the very butch character who likes horses, big horses. Oh, me and Rora, we were up in the park and we were riding horses.
So, are you really getting real life or?
Well, part-time. I have a wife and my other hobby is making children. So I have another one on the way. So I've got two children, one on the way. So I'm a part-time gay. Wife doesn't mind me borrowing the clothes or the lipstick.
Have you worked for Brendan before?
I did. I worked with Brendan about, what, 2.5 years ago on this very show, Good Morning, Mrs. Brown.
On stage.
On stage. And before that, I worked with him and the gang in Panto in Glasgow. It was fucking a nightmare. Oh, sorry, I'm allowed to swear on camera.
No, don't do it.
Oh! So yes, I've worked with Brendan before, and it's just like coming back to see the family again.
How you doing, John?
Good, how are you?
What's your job title on this, John?
It varies. I think it's producer, but I don't take that too seriously.
No. Have you worked on with Brendan before?
Yeah, and these are unique productions because Brendan is about the most organised creative person on the planet. So all I do is see that a few things are put in place and let them on with it.
The genius planner, silent and invisible, going from place to place without being seen, going around in the darkness like a shadow. And very much feared.
I don't think you'll get through.
Going around from place to place. I think I made a ball to Danny.
Just came away, John. Cheers, pal.
John. Be careful.
I'd met Brendan over the years at things like when I used to produce a Late Late Show or Open House or something like that. And we were chatting about 2 or more years ago, and he was saying he wanted to make a video of the plays, and he had talked to various people and it didn't seem to be happening. So I said, well, sure, I'd organise it, and put together the crew, he put together the script, and it all happened 2 years ago. And each year it gets easier and easier and easier, and I think this one is going to be far and away the best one. It really is terrific watching this one.
How's it going, Robbie?
How you doing?
What are you playing in this production?
I'm playing a Mormon called Elder Peachum. Ken is Ken Doherty's Elder Bush, so we're two Mormons.
In 3, 2.
That was a good laugh. It's something that, you know, I really enjoyed. A bit different than what I usually do, but that was a good crack.
And how do you know Brendan?
I met Brendan through a friend of mine, Brian Whitehead, who sourced me out a lot of tickets, and the family loved Brendan, and we loved going to see him, seeing the play. So I went to the players and spoke to him a few times on the phone, and basically just spoke to him on the phone a good few times, and I met him then, good laughing, but he's a smashing bloke. And it's very hard to work it when you're on the set there, because he just makes you laugh all the time, so.
His
fucking hell will give you a load. But yeah, he's a good chap, and as I said, I really enjoyed myself today.
You think this could be a career from the football back?
No chance. I reckon I had about 40 scenes or 40 takes, so. But it was good, as I said, I enjoyed it. But it's probably something I wouldn't do, but to do something like this and sort of the experience of it was a bit different than, as I said, what I do usually and play football, but it's something that I really enjoyed, and it's something, you know, if I came across again that I'd do a few scenes or something, but it takes very long to do a few scenes. I don't know if that's just me acting or just the way it goes, but the main thing was I enjoyed myself, and as I said, it was a great crack meeting all the crew, Brendan and, you know, Jenny and a whole lot of things. Good crack.
That's great. Sorry.
Cheers, no problem.
What do you do on this production, Brendan?
I do a bit of the catering, a little bit of the
we do pickups in the mornings, driving. And a little bit of acting. Only direct as well, yeah. Just a little bit.
So, Brian, how did the production go for you?
I don't think it could have gotten any better. We got absolutely everything we wanted for. Needless to say, all the people from Mrs. Brown who've been in the stage production were absolutely wonderful, exactly as they expected.
Loads of it is made up. Like Moses, the runner. Do you know Moses? No, not the runner. In the desert. But yeah. Now, God gave him... Now, listen. God gave him the commandments. 10 of them. And what did he write them on? What did he write them on? No. Tablets. 2 tablets. Jesus, and they'd want to be sulpidine before you could fucking read it. Do you know? I'm not finished. Wait.
But the surprises for me were certainly Robbie Keane and Ken Doherty's performance was wow. I mean, I expected them to come along and you know, have a bit of fun, but they actually had rehearsed and they had done a great job. And as you can see in the video you've just, on the DVD you've just watched, they were brilliant. Well done, boys.
How is? Are you the two that he sent?
You mean the man upstairs?
Well, he's in the kitchen now, but yes.
We certainly are. We are here to shine a light on the path to God. And may I say, we are delighted with such a welcome.
Brendan, just how do you get these guys involved, like the celebrities?
In some cases we ask, and in some cases they ask. I'm not going to tell you which is which. But it's just, it's kind of like Mrs. Brown's become a cult in Ireland and certainly in the United Kingdom. And I think it's got to the stage, it's kind of like, wait up with you. Guinness, is it? It's kind of like, unless you've been in a Mrs. Brown movie, you can't really say you're somebody. But it's, anybody I've asked have said yes. And we've got over the last 3 DVDs, we've had an amazing array of celebrities. They've all said yes, everybody we asked said yes. I think it's the irresistible charm of Mrs. Brown herself, or else Tretz.
Brendan, what's the plans for the future?
Oh, God. Well, I think I'd like to see Mrs. Brown on the big screen in the cinema. I think it's time for that. And if it happens, it happens. If it doesn't, it'll be on a new DVD. But either way, it doesn't matter. She's getting to a huge audience, and that's all we do it for. We do it for, you know, I say it at the end of every stage show, and I'll say it at the end of this DVD. I hope you enjoyed what you saw, because what you saw, we all performed, and I wrote especially for you.
I think this is pretty unfair. I think I'm being judged fairly harshly in consideration. I'm early all the time. Just this one time, this one time! I misjudged the traffic. That was it. That was all. Just one little mistake.
One little mistake.
And I suffer. Bren. I'm sorry, man. I'm sorry.